Well, you've learned a few tools for controlling execution of your code, but I still haven't found the cause of this bug, and there's no way I can ship my Schmecklist app with a bug like this. In this exercise, you'll see how to view the values of variables in order to understand what's going on with your code.
In Schmecklist view controller, set a breakpoint in the init method on line 105, then build and run. Down here in the debug area on the left, you'll see a variables view. If you don't see this, make sure the debug area is visible, or click on this button to toggle it. Then click this button in the lower right to show the variables view. Here, Xcode is using the term variables generically to describe both variables and constants in your code. In this view, Xcode chooses the variables to show you based on where you're paused. In a minute, you'll learn how to view exactly what you want, but for now, expand row 4 item by clicking this disclosure triangle. Now you can see the properties of this item and see that the checked property is true. Set another breakpoint in table view self-arrow at index path on line 170 and click continue. Make sure that item is expanded by clicking the disclosure triangle. And you can see that this is creating the cell for the walk the dog item. Click continue, and Xcode will update the variables view with the new values for the second item, and you can see that's brush my teeth. Click it a few more times until the text property says eat ice cream. This is the buggy little item that isn't showing right, and sure enough, you can see that the checked property is false when the cell is being created for this item. So somewhere in between init, where you saw that it was true, and here, the property is changing to false. You'll actually fix this bug as the challenge in the next video, but before we proceed to that, I want to show you a little more about inspecting variables. Set a breakpoint in configure text on line 178. It might seem a little weird to set the breakpoint on the closing brace, but you want to inspect the state after the text property is set on the label. Click continue and execution will pause at the new breakpoint. In the variables view, click the disclosure triangle next to label and then the one on UIKit UI view. Now you can see lots of properties on this instance, but it may be hard to find just what you want, or in some cases, it might not even show the property that you're looking for. The variables view is a quick visual way to inspect some values, but many times you need to go a little deeper. Click on the label row, and then click this little I button at the bottom. This will cause a description of the label instance to be printed to the console. You can accomplish the same thing by typing this in the console. You can remember this command by thinking of PO as standing for print object. This prints what's called the debug description of the object. In this case, the debug description of the label includes the text, but it's mixed in with a lot of other properties of the label. You can also type just what you're looking for. And you can see we even got code completion help. Now for one more trick up my sleeve. You can even change the values while execution is paused, and when you resume, the code will use the new values. Type this. It doesn't look like anything happened, but deactivate all the breakpoints and continue. The text of the label reflects what you just typed.
In this case, you just changed the text of the label. But be aware, if you changed your model object or some other variable, that can have an impact on how the rest of the code runs. This is a pretty powerful tool for making changes without having to stop and add code. But with great power comes great responsibility. Just know that if things misbehave somewhere down the line, it could be because of the changes you made when paused and not anything to do with an error in your code. On another note, it can be really helpful to construct your code in a way that makes it easier to inspect. For example, if you call a method and pass its return value to another method, that can be really hard to debug. But instead, if you store the return value in a constant and then pass that to the other method, if you break at this point, it's much easier to see the return value before continuing on.
Inspecting variables and changing them are powerful tools when debugging your apps, but there are a lot of other debugging tools as well. To continue watching and to learn about these tools, head on over to raywunderlich.com and give this course a watch. Cheers.